when I was growing up in Colorado Springs, my mother remarried. And she married another man that I was 5 years old. When I was 6 months old, my biological father left our family. He left home. I never knew my biological father. I have one picture of him holding me when I was 6 months old. So from the time that picture was taken, I don't know the length of time between that picture and when he decided to leave our family. And we grew up, particularly because I was the youngest out of my mother's children. I'm one of four, so I'm the youngest child. He was not discussed. My mother refused to discuss him, and it was because she had not dealt with the pain and the hurt that happened between the two of them. But she did not allow us to speak of him at all. So I had so many questions, and I'm sure like many of you who have possibly experienced the lack of your father in your life, you may not understand why he left. You may not understand why, or maybe it's your mother who left. But for me, I just didn't understand why he left. So when I was about 15 or 16 years old, I told my elder sister and my elder brothers that I had a desire to seek out my biological father. When I decided to tell my mother, she had a breakdown in front of us and she exploded in anger and in rage. I also grew up right on the same street as the KKK. You heard that right. We had the Ku Klux Klan on my street. Three families in particular that I know were Ku Klux Klan because they were proud and they were loud about it. So I grew up walking the streets of a town where we had to be home by a certain time before the street light turned on, as my mama would say. And if we weren't home by this time the street light was on, we got whipped, or as some people would call it, we got beat, because she wanted to make sure that we were safe. And so we had times where the neighbors that did not like our hue, our culture, our melanin, we had some neighbors that let us know very much so that they did not like us. They were very forthright. They were very honest with it. They were very abrupt with it. But then we had some of those sneaky neighbors, some of those covert neighbors who would smile in your face and say good morning in your face, but in secret, they hated your guts. How do I know that they hated our guts? Because I went to school with their children.